I like to introduce a lifelong friend to talk to you, and the daughter, the eldest daughter of Sean Mack, who's dotted all this. Imagine that. That's the way they played the music. That is the way the LPs, long players, for those of you too young to know what an LP is, long playing records, that's the way they were recorded. That's the way it was, and it was the year I was born. And that's not today or yesterday. I think it's fabulous, okay? So, the daughter of the man responsible for all of this gorgeous music, Máire McNamara.
I'm just going to say something very quickly, and I know Ray won't want me to do this, but I'm going to do it anyhow. It's a big thanks to Ray on behalf of my mum, my two sisters and Trish. And I suspect all the band members' families, and I suspect all of us in West Clare actually, for Ray getting together, putting a lot of hard work into your book. Not a great welcome to all the Kilmahill McNamaras who are all here. Woo! It's lovely to see our friends and family, Cameron, they're all the family here, Milltown Gang. And my cousin Tessie says to me, I said, Tessie, Ray's got some cousins coming. She goes, thank goodness for that, more all these McNamaras. There's three of Ray's cousins here today, and I think it's great they've come as well. Marion, Rita, and Sheila, thanks for coming. So, anyway, I'll go on now.
You'll be kept.
Oh God. The band tour in 1964 included three dates in Clare: Kilmahill on the 26th of July, Mullock on the 28th, and Carrigahote on the 29th. Sean Mack's father came from the townland of Castle Park, just outside Kilmahill, for Kilmahill too. And he had many relatives in the area. I hasten to say a lot of them here today. His cousin Margot O'Reilly, Nee McNamara, the fiddle player, was married to Eddie, and they lived in the village of Kilmahill. She was older than Sean Mack, and when he was a teenager, she taught him local tunes. He would always credit Margot as being a significant influence on his playing. Margot's daughter Tessie was going out with Jay Garry at this time, and he would prove to be very influential in the story of the band. Jay loved the music, and he was a tour manager for them when they were over in Ireland. As Frank said, Jay was a real organiser. We'd call him the engineer. That was because he got things fixed. Being in Clare for the band was being like being at home. The welcome and the hospitality they received here was second to none. Tessie and the rest of the family and neighbours were enthusiastic supporters of the band. On one occasion when the band were touring in Clare, Crookie had not been able to travel with the rest of the musicians. Sorry. And he arrived the next day. Arrangements were put in place for him to have a meal in Kilmahill before joining up with the others. It's a story that Maura told me many years ago. When the band were over in Clare, they were staying with different people in and around Kilmahill and had meals at different houses. Crookie was to go to Tessie's parents' house, the O'Reillys, for his dinner. Crookie went into what he thought was the O'Reillys' house and was given a great welcome and told to sit down. He had a lovely meal. A few hours later, talking to other members of the band, he realised he'd gone to the wrong house. He'd actually gone into the Neen's house, which is a couple of doors down the street. He couldn't believe the welcome and the great food he'd received, even though he'd gone to the wrong house.
We don't really know lots of the names of all the tunes that actually on set list, but if we just call them by the first tunes. It's a Cooley set, but it's Cooley's, Father Kelly's, and the Old Bush. For those of you who don't know where that came from, but, yeah.